going on, beautiful people? Welcome back to Funnelheads. Today we're going to be talking about a not so fun topic, but one that a lot of people do have questions about, and that is the vaccine exemption letter. But first, before we get into that, if you're new to the channel or returning and you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so, becoming part of that Funnelhead family. We'd love to have you. Also, commenting and liking on the video is much appreciated and does truly help the channel grow. So thank you so much for doing that. So let's get right into the video. So for this video, I am going to be reading just a little bit to make sure that we get the important information out. Also, this information is coming from our past experience, since we were lucky enough to go on 2 Carnival cruises this summer, and our little one needed to get the approved exemption letter before he can go on, because of course he's unvaccinated since he's only 4. But let's get right into it. So if you are traveling with somebody that is unvaccinated, they will absolutely need to get this approved exemption letter before the cruise. Now, currently only 5% of unvaccinated guests are allowed to cruise with Carnival, and this includes not only kids that are under 12 years old, but it also includes medical exemptions as well as religious exemptions. This unfortunately means that not all unvaccinated guests are going to be able to cruise, even if they are booked and the cruise is paid for. So how this works is basically, once you book the cruise, Carnival will reach out to you in the form of a survey under your booking for each individual in your cabin. Now, there are 3 options on the survey. One being, are you fully vaccinated? 2, you are not fully vaccinated, but plan to be fully vaccinated at least 14 days before the cruise. And 3, you are not fully vaccinated, you don't plan to be fully vaccinated, but you do plan to have the exemption, the vaccination exemption approval before your cruise. Now, once you submit these surveys, hopefully, my advice is to do it immediately, as soon as you see it, submit it, because that will start the process of Carnival going through each cabin and basically either approving or denying those unvaccinated guests. Now, since our son was unvaccinated, we had to do this, and we actually didn't find out until about a week before we were supposed to cruise. Now, we all know Carnival just started up a couple of months ago, so I would imagine this process is going to be much quicker in the future, I hope anyway, but there are a few guests on our sailings that didn't find out until a few days before, which is really unfortunate, and some of them were unfortunately denied, so that really throws a wrench into travel plans. So just expect, you know, if you are traveling with an unvaccinated guest, you know, this is a process, and you know, there can be worst case scenarios that happen, unfortunately, with, you know, denials being one of them. Now, currently we've asked a lot of different, you know, employees, whether it was, you know, PVPs, or just, you know, the person that answers the phones, you know, employees on the ship, whether there's a certain process for criteria to be either approved or denied, and unfortunately nobody can say for sure. The only rumor is that it goes by who submitted the survey the quickest, but I cannot confirm or deny that that's a thing. So, but just be safe and try to, you know, fill it out as soon as humanly possible, so that way you can take that off the table. But anyway, I know it wasn't like, you know, a fun video or anything, but it is a video that people need to know about, expectations, all that good stuff. So anyway, if you need me to clear up any information or have any questions about any part of the process, please let me know. Just here to help, answer questions, all that good stuff. But hopefully I'll see you right back here in the next video, or on a cruise ship one day. Catch you later.